Hello there and welcome to another special edition of Iron Port, proudly brought to you by West Blue Consulting, Ghana Oil Company Limited, and also Ghana Community Network Services. The proud media partner is the Business and Financial Times. And this week, we are revisiting the International Maritime Hospital because FIFA Medical Research Coordinator, as well as CAF Medical Instructor, has commended this particular hospital you see behind me, the International Maritime Hospital. And they have already inspected some of the facilities here, and they believe that very, very soon, even the sports organizing associations like FIFA, CAF, GFA will be assessing the facilities here to test the ages of bones of sportsmen, including all our soccer players. So we had a chat with Dr. Prince Pambo, as well as Dr. Anna Bisi, the head of medical services of GPHA. Dr. Prince Pambo, a medical research coordinator for the Federation of International Football Association, FIFA, has much admired the International Maritime Hospital, constructed by the Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority, GPHA, and described it as strategically positioned to aid football governing bodies in Ghana, Africa, and the world in their medical research works.
There are some research protocols that the governing bodies like IOC, FIFA, CAF will send down, and it will come with specifications that you probably need this particular type of a machine to do it. I mean, like a 3 Tesla machine. And obviously, I mean, then it puts us as a nation, it puts us right to be able to attract some of these works to our country. And of course, it propels us as a nation forward. So yes, I mean, it's the only one so far.
Dr. Prince Pambo, who is also the Confederation of African Football CAF Sports Medical Instructor, expressed gratification following his tour of the hospital's facilities.
We are normally very keen on diagnostics. So sports is money, and time is money as well. So the reason why we are keen with diagnostics is that you should be able to diagnose exactly what is wrong with your player, and then you should be able to tell your player exactly when. I mean, not only football player, when I use the word player, but a sportsman and women, you should be able to tell them exactly when they are coming back to play and all that. And what I saw here, I mean, I've seen theaters, I've seen MRI machines, I've seen x-ray units, I've seen CT scan units. These are the various things we need to do our diagnostics.
He said the ultra-modern equipment installed in the facility, especially the MRI, which is the first of its kind in West Africa, makes it attractive to corporations and individuals who will require their services to carry out varying tests, including ages of sportsmen.
Your MRI here is actually a 3 Tesla. I mean, the only one in West Africa. And I mean, 3 Tesla simply means it gives you a better resolution. What others might not be able to find, you can find it. And we have it sitting here. So, and I mean, I mentioned the x-rays, the CT scans. I mean, there's a physiotherapy department. There are 5 theaters, and I believe one of them is going to be doing orthopedic surgeries. There's an arthroscopic machine. So what we want for our sportsmen and women is you come to a place and it's a one-stop shop, you know. And I think this hospital is going to be providing all that.
It means that GPH can understand the benefit. It means other people will look into us, they will look into us, up to us, to be able to help them to diagnose their diseases, to diagnose their injuries, and to help us to help to what to fix those problems as fast as possible for them to go back and make more money.
The head of medical services of the Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority, Dr. Anna Bisi, hinted that the facility forms part of the Port Authority's contribution to the development of the health needs of Ghanaians.
The wealth of a nation is in the health of its people. You cannot have people who are not healthy. They cannot produce. Productivity will be almost approaching zero. So if you don't take good care of your people, or if you don't take their health serious, obviously, our organization will stand to lose, will not benefit, will pay more, people will be sick all the time, you don't get the right care, it means that they are going to be losing, the organization will lose economic manpower, man hours, because if people are always sick and they are on excuse duty because they cannot get the quick cure for their diseases, they are going to stay away from work. Yeah. For that matter, the organization will stand to lose.
Yeah.
And then this would replicate throughout the nation, and that is not what we're looking for. We're saying that organizations which have the muscle and which can afford to help, this is how this is our widow's mite,
yeah,
in terms of contribution to development of this.
The medical experts describe the International Maritime Hospital as rescuer to sports medicine due to the availability of the 17 automated external defibrillator, AED, a portal device that checks the heart rhythm and can send an electric shock to the heart to restore a normalcy of rhythm to the heart.
This is the hospital that I've seen the most AEDs. Dr. Nab, how many did you say you have?
We have 17.
17 automated external defibrillators. These are life-saving machines. I mean, we've had issues of sudden cardiac death all over the place. I have suffered a lot of it because I think within the last about 2 months, we've had about 7 sports people, coaches, I mean, administrators, and of course, active players dying. I mean, our own brother Uriah Asante died just last week of cardiac arrest, and we have been preaching, we can't do much to stop cardiac arrest, but what we do as a people is to be able to improve upon our interventions, you know. And the AED, which is an external defibrillator, is one of the crucial machines. If you heard of Fabrice Muamba, who suffered a cardiac arrest and survived, he survived because there was an AED there, and they used it and used it right. And I mean, I have as many as 17 in this particular facility. That alone makes it a very safe place, I mean, for people to come.
Aside sports, Dr. Anap said the International Maritime Hospital will serve as a one-stop shop for the medical needs of Ghanaians who would patronize the facility.
Well, facility, 130-bed hospital to begin. We're having 5 theaters.
That's massive.
Saying that we're opening up, we're broad enough to receive any kind of thing. This is not all of it. The diagnostic imaging is a major aspect. Dr. Pambo has spoken a lot about it already, about the radiology bit. But there's laboratory medicine. We have a modern lab which we're looking at getting it accredited to international standards to be able to provide that kind of competitive service so that you can come in here and do, if you're coming to do annual medicals, if you're coming to do a wellness checkup, you come in here, you'll be taken through right from our public health unit, you'll be taken through, you can have physical examination, then you have the laboratory to complement you.
If a facility like this, I mean, is placing itself uniquely, I mean, having probably the only 3 Tesla machine, the people come, there's an arthroscopic machine, there's a good physiotherapy unit. I mean, you don't necessarily need to even ask the people to contract you. You would just have to, I mean, you attract them.
I see.
I mean, you probably will not be in a position to look elsewhere than to come to a place where you would get the best of services. And I believe personally that, I mean, with such an investment, I mean, you're thinking about a human resource, and I'm sure this place is also going to attract some of the best in the country to come and work. You know, I mean, I've seen the wards. I mean, I saw a huge ward, and there were only 2 beds. I asked Dr. Nab whether you were coming to add 6 more. He said, no, this is, a side ward, going to take 2 people. That alone, I mean, I think it's quite...
facilities.
That's right. It's attractive enough, I mean, for the kind of people we work with. So from that point, like I said, I mean, once we are looking for a good place for our people to render the best of services to, and this place strategically places itself for that, I think you are in good business.
He said a trump card of the modern hospital is the fact that the hospital has its own oxygen plant to produce sufficient amount of oxygen and engage in commercial supplies as well.
We have our own oxygen supply. We manufacture our own oxygen, produce our own oxygen. So we have an oxygen plant which has got excess capacity, and we're looking at providing a service to other hospitals which do not have
this facility. So in this hospital, you can provide oxygen for other
hospitals.
Yeah. Dr. Prince Pambo again hinted that one thing that is lacking in the sports arena in Africa is a wide accredited laboratory for testing banned substances, and challenged GPHA to collaborate with the World Anti-Doping Agency to set up one in the International Maritime Hospital, a one-stop facility for sports medicine.
In our sports area, one thing we think we are lacking in Africa is a WADA accredited laboratory for testing banned substances.
Yeah.
I think we had about 2 in Africa, And one of them, I think, has been closed down because WADA, which is a World Anti-Doping Agency, wasn't confident with, the results they were turning. That's right. So I think now, I'm not 100% sure, but I think currently we have only one in Africa. And I'll challenge GPHA to put in the necessary steps, put up the lab, get those accreditation, approach WADA. In fact, the Ghana Olympic Committee can even let you have the requirements for WADA accreditation, and let's work towards that. And I think this is one of the passions of the Ghana Football Association president personally. He feels that Ghana should have a center that can test banned substances.
Well, a lot of praises for the Port Authority there for putting up this particular facility, and we hope that as they continue to stock it with all those facilities and equipment, very, very soon the healthcare needs of the entire country and even beyond will be changing. Ion Port returns after the break.
Hello.
Good morning. This is Samantha Wendy's. I am sending a purchase order from SAT Ventures International.
Lovely.
For pineapples.
For how many containers?
Our policy for new supplies is 2 containers to start with, but you must deliver within 30 days.
Don't worry at all. I'm going to get you the 4 containers within 30 days or less.
Congratulations, Mr. Apia. You have just secured your first order from SAT Ventures International. Time to process the paperwork. Do you remember you have exactly 30 days to deliver? To get his pineapple slices from his country to his clients overseas, Mr. Apia and his representatives have to complete a number of regulatory compliance procedures to various international trade stakeholders. For instance, he has to obtain financial documents such as letters of credit, payment receipts and invoices, complete regulatory documents such as declarations, make permit applications, obtain food hygiene certificates, complete transportation documentations such as manifest, bill of lading, and manage port requirements. Going round and round in circles and up and down from office to office, doing the same paperwork over and over again. Stop! Does it really have to be this way? In a single window environment, Mr. Apia can complete processes for his sales invoice, manifest, declaration, permits, certificates, letters of credit, payment receipts, licenses, and all other international trade supply chain processes. Assessing all agencies and stakeholders in one place 24/7. Let's see what happens when Mr. Apia trades in a single window environment. Using single window, Mr. Apia has completed all his international trade procedures through one portal. He has registered his company information, applied for the necessary permit, certificates and licenses, and all that remains is for him to get a text alert for clearance and movement of goods.
Hello, good morning. You just ordered 2 container pineapple slices. I was wondering, can I supply you the goods as well?
And that's how simple facilitating international trade could be in a single window environment. You can offer competitive services to your trading partners in China, America, England, India, and yes, even here, in a simpler, faster, and cost-effective way. Single window, the only way to Ghana's economic growth, is in our hands.
Making sure say we engine no see a sound. With the Gore Synthetic Oil and our Goil Engine Oil, who do not move BIA service here, a massage engine, you know, give you trans solid protection, manon and teacher, makani trimusu yene de de. Gore Synthetic Oil, diesel engine dianku, and a petrol su dianku. Kaisa waka nutra 15,000 kilometers BIA with the Gore Synthetic Oil best servicing.
Well, you're a champion. That's why I, Azuma Nelson, 3-time world boxing champion and a patriot, always choose Goil.
I'm Winnie Pankasa. Goil, good energy.
For all ship repairs and maintenance work, count on the Takoradi Shipyard. Bye. Takoradi Shipyard, efficiency, reliability, and perfection.
Welcome back from the break. Still watching Eye on Port, and coming up next, news and activities happening in and around the port and maritime industry, including the first ever auctioning processes in the port by customs that you are yet to see on TV. The Ghana Community Network Services Limited, GCNET, an information and communication technology public-private partnership with a mandate to provide e-solutions to government, has presented a final dividend of 10 million Ghana cedis to the government, bringing its total dividend for the 2015 operational year to 25 million Ghana cedis.
And although we are a government agency, we are liable to the taxation policies of the country, and for 2015 alone, we paid income tax of about 25 million Ghana cedis, VAT of about 20 million Ghana cedis, withholding tax of about 4 million Ghana cedis, and all this in explaining and establishing the fact that we are a responsible company, we are a responsible partner, and we believe that the public-private partnership that has been established over these years to further revenue mobilization and trade facilitation has been a resounding success.
The government, through the Ghana Revenue Authority, GRA, holds equity stake in GCNET. We started operations in 2004 and improved collections from customs duties at the country's entry points. The executive chairman of GCNET, Dr. Note Omabo, presented the check to the Deputy Minister of Finance and Economic Planning, Mona Helen Korte, who received it on behalf of the government. Mona Korte commended GCNET for its consistency in the payment of dividend to government. She said the Tax Revenue Integrated Processing System, TRIPS, module being implemented by GCNET should be deployed fully to improve the tax collection of government.
We admit that the system's information that is churned out have definitely been useful in our compliance efforts and in helping to improve the overall tax revenue collection. In line with our tax modernization efforts, we hope that the TRIPS, Tax Revenue Integrated Processing System modules, all the modules will be deployed and operationalized in the large taxpayer office and the medium taxpayer's office by the end of this year to improve our tax collections.
Dr. Mabo said GCNET has in the last 2 years increased investments by deploying new systems, including the e-register system for the Registrar General's Department and enhancement in warehousing management within the import management system.
We look forward to enhancing and deepening our collaboration with the government. As far as single window concept is concerned, I mean, this is one that has been in existence for several years, and we are fully committed to ensuring that the full potential is realized to the benefit of this country.
The Customs Division of the Ghana Revenue Authority has held a public auction of general goods that were confiscated by the state for several reasons, including lack of funds to clear the goods. The auction was held on the 1st and 2nd of June in Kumasi for auctioning of vehicles. While another was held on the 8th and 9th of June 2016 in Tema for general goods. The public has consistently been advised to clear their goods on time to prevent a situation where they caution to people who have no idea how the goods got into Ghana.
This cargo yields revenue to the state and customs as well. So when they fail to come and then clear these goods, it means that government is losing revenue. Now, the state warehouse might put in these arrangements by auctioning them. What about this cargo which go bad? It means that some money will have to also be sourced to go and then effect this sort of destruction. And then it will not help anybody. The goods which are meant for the public will only end up for destruction.
Businesses have been urged to sign up for the Samsung digital signage in order to improve their business performance. Digital signage is a specialized form of silver casting in which video or multimedia content is displayed in public places for informational or advertising purposes. Some of its benefits include reducing cost with increased operational efficiency in customer and business processes, and also increased revenue with new and high impact digital experiences for customers. Samsung is urging institutions within the port community and other corporate bodies to patronize such facilities to make information dissemination readily and adequately accessible.
All sectors, government, once you're a company and you have some data to display to grow your business, retain your customers, then you need Samsung's digital signage solution.
At a business solutions seminar organized by Samsung Electronics West Africa Limited and attended by a number of corporate organizations including the Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority, the business development manager for Samsung Business Enterprise Solutions said businesses stand to increase their profitability by using the digital signage.
We need to move towards digital signage. The reason being that it's going to really add value to your business, cut down unnecessary costs that the currently incurring, and also improve profitability of their businesses.
Hello.
Good morning, this is Samantha Wendy's. I am sending a purchase order from SAT Ventures International.
Lovely.
For pineapples.
For how many containers?
Our policy for new supplies is 2 containers to start with, but you must deliver within 30 days.
Don't worry at all. I'm going to get you the 4 containers within 30 days or less.
Congratulations, Mr. Pierre. You have just secured your first order from SA2 Ventures International. Time to process the paperwork. Do you remember you have exactly 30 days to deliver? To get his pineapple slices from his country to his clients overseas, Mr. Pierre and his representatives have to complete a number of regulatory compliance procedures to various international trade stakeholders. For instance, he has to obtain financial documents such as letters of credit, payment receipts and invoices, complete regulatory documents such as declarations, make permit applications, obtain food hygiene certificates, complete transportation documentations such as manifest, bill of lading, and manage port requirements. Going round and round in circles and up and down from office to office, doing the same paperwork over and over again. Stop! Does it really have to be this way? In a single window environment, Mr. Apia can complete processes for his sales invoice, manifest, declarations, permits, certificates, letters of credit, payment receipts, licenses, and all other international trade supply chain processes. Assessing all agencies and stakeholders in one place 24/7. Let's see what happens when Mr. Apia trades in a single window environment. Using single window, Mr. Apia has completed all his international trade procedures through one portal. He has registered his company information, applied for the necessary permit, certificates and licenses, and all that remains is for him to get a text alert for clearance and movement of goods. And that's how simple facilitating international trade could be in a single window environment. You can offer competitive services to your trading partners in China, America, England, India, and yes, even here, in a simpler, faster, and cost-effective way. Single window, the only way to Ghana's economic growth, is in our hands.
Wax your car, polish it, valet it, steam it. Make sure your engine is sound. With the Gore Synthetic Oil and our Goyle Engine Oil, who do not move BIA service here, and massage engine, no, GF Tran Solid Protection, Mano Nanti Check, Makani Tumusu Yeni the Dead. Gore Synthetic Oil, Diesel Engine Dianco, and a Petron Su Dianco. Kaiso Wakan Ultra 15,000 kilometers BIA with the Gore Synthetic Oil best servicing.
Gore, well, yeah, champion. That's why I, Azuma Nelson, 3 times world boxing champion and a patriot, always choose Goil.
I'm Winnie Pankasa. Goil, good energy.
For all ship repairs and maintenance work, count on the Takoradi Shipyard. Takoradi Shipyard, efficiency, reliability, and perfection.
The schedules of vessels sitting in the port, those at anchorage, plus those suspected for the week, and the Bank of Ghana exchange rate for this week next. Now your comments and queries also next.
I am Dr. Bwedi, a general surgeon. Please, when is the International Maritime Hospital employing surgeons? According to the head of medical services of GPHA, Dr. Nab, the committee tasked to recruit has already started working and all interested specialists are being considered. My name is Dr. Yao Edujenfi. Of all the specialists enumerated, one did not hear of anesthetist, pediatricians and pathologists at the International Maritime Hospital. Dr. Edujenfi, a number of other specialists were also referred to by Dr. Nab, but unfortunately, our editorial time constraint did not allow all the mentions. I am a cardiac physiologist who has worked at Kolebu Cardio from 1994 to 2016 in charge of 24-hour ECG hot tap monitoring. Please, I want to find out if there is any opportunity at the International Maritime Hospital. Indeed, Doc, we understand the committee in charge of recruiting has already started working and all interested specialists are being considered.
That's it for this week's episode of Iron Port. Thank you for watching the program. Also, thanks to the crew, Robert Nyantechi, Godwin Kabute, Beneza Tewia, Solomon Anderson, Joe Lavo, the executive producers, Paul Asariansa, and Abna Sewa Opokufusu. Thank you for watching.